actually they're one of the giants in African football. And I think also playing against Tunisia, favorites, and performing the way they did, it again shows what they're capable of doing. So to me, I think Mali, Tunisia, it was one of the best games, hardest games, and even if Tunisia were favorites, I think Mali were favorites as well.
How come that West African teams do not really show a lot of respect to North African teams, but when it comes to African teams, we seem to buckle under pressure from the North African teams?
I think it is just that rivalry, the long-time rivalry, whereby actually they consider the North Africans to be close to Europe. So it's always a difficult contest. Even if you see Nigeria, Ghana, when they meet these guys, it's always like a final. And they say, oh, let's give our all. There's no time to relax. It's either we win or we go for the penalties, maybe during the knockout stages.
The Rwandese could be mourning the fact that they were eliminated by Congo DR, but the fact that they were eliminated means that Tuyisenge is now free to join Gor Mahia. Is that good news to the Gor Mahia nation that he's coming back?
Not yet for Gor Mahia, because the paperwork are yet not yet done. So it's still a procedure. I don't know if they have acquired his release from police. So for Rwanda, it was a good tournament for them. They didn't expect maybe to reach that far, having been the host. But I'm so sad for Kenya, because Kenya, as the next host, we should have been there.
We should have been there
because we have what it takes to be in that tournament.
The only good thing, we have already qualified as the hosts.
Yeah.
And
but who knows? Who knows if we are going to actually host it?
What I'm saying, the federation, and maybe we don't know whether it's the incumbent president who will retain the seat, or maybe we'll have the new president. But what I'm saying, this time we have got enough time to go there and try to structure, try to work out. Two stadiums are enough. Two stadiums are enough. Toskin. And I think what we
Rwanda do, Rwanda have used three stadia. Let's go back. Let's go back to the point of Jackie Tuyisenge, now free to join Gor Mahia. You may have watched him play. Do you think he's a good addition as we move on towards the KPL transfers?
And maybe because you talked about that, looking at Tuyisenge, the way he played, I can just say, unless he proves me otherwise, that Medi Kagere was far better than Tuyisenge. That is according to what I saw him do for Rwanda. So unless he proves me otherwise, I will say that no, they have not really found a replacement for me.
Will he be a good addition to Gor Mahia?
To me, Tuyisenge is just an average player from what he has so far displayed. I think it will be hard for him to replace Kagere. Maybe Kelly, some glimpses here and there, but not yet.
Who has done good business? We know that the transfer window is now coming to a close in the Kenyan Premier League. Which team do you think has done good business?
I think Bandari. Bandari has really done a good business. Bandari and Tusker. Actually, they've brought in experienced players. You see now, Bandari took two FC Leopards players, that's Mangoli and Wafula. They also brought in Serenkuma experience. They also brought in Mesha Karani. They also brought in Edwin Lavazza. That means these guys are really serious. And 2016 is going to be a very tough year. Three or four teams will be competing for the title. That is Ulinzi, there's Tusker, there's Bandari, there's Gor Mahia, and maybe Rangers
have done quite something.
Yeah.
But when people talk about clubs doing business, they will mention Gor Mahia, Tusker. FC Leopards doesn't feature anywhere.
FC Leopards, looking at the players they signed and those they let go, they'll struggle to make these players gel. I was looking at their midfield, for example, like Bernard Ongoma is a good player. We have seen him perform. Looking at the inclusion of Alan Katerega, we have seen what he can do with Ushuru. But you see, this is a completely new squad. Apart from, let's say, Indeche, Masika, Nasio, and let's say five, six players, the others are completely new players. So it will take them time to gel. Looking at Gor Mahia, they have retained most of the players, apart from Medi Kagere and Olunga. And looking at Kahata, we know Kahata what he's capable of doing. We saw him before going to Tarana, and now he's back. We know Kelly what they can do. And adding that pressure from the fans, I think Robin Toskin, Gor Mahia will still be a team to beat. Talking of Bandari, he has talked about Serunkuma. The question we should ask ourselves, will Serunkuma still bring what he had, or he just went and turned out to be useless Terry Nkrumah. But I remember asking Muhyiddin the same question.
Sure.
And he said he had done that with Tom Juma. He had done that with John Barazo, Wale Tosarian. Mm. So he's also expecting to revive this Terry Nkrumah.
We know he thrived really because of the fans also getting behind him, supporting him. We know that Bandari doesn't command the kind of following like Gor Mahia. I don't know how that will pan out to be. But then AFC Leopards, the issues, they're saying they have a sponsor, they don't have a sponsor. What is happening, Rogers?
It's not yet known. Maybe let's wait for 1 or 2 weeks to come. Maybe they'll come up clear and tell us, hey, this is the sponsor. Because from my sources, I gather that there's two betting companies who want to sponsor the club, but nobody has come out to tell us who actually these guys have brought on board. So we are waiting for the officials, though there's still wrangles here and there who wants to take on the percentage. And but at the end of the day, it's the players who are going to suffer, and the fans also are going to suffer.
Let's wrap up now with a bit of volleyball, because the national women's volleyball team, Malkia Strikers, are bracing themselves for a tough Rio Olympics qualification tournament that serves off on February 12th in Yaounde, Cameroon. Despite having had a remarkable 2015 season, we saw them win the World Grand Prix Group 3, and also they have retained the African Nations Cup. Rogers, you've been following the women volleyball team. We are heading to Cameroon on February 12th. What do you make of our chances, especially that we are meeting Algeria?
Of course, we are going there as favorites, but it's not going to be an easy task for the Malakia Strikers. Because you see, there's teams like Algeria who have qualified for the last two editions, that is 2008 and in Beijing, and also 2012 in London. So all these guys are coming there knowing actually still have a chance. Though Kenya beat Algeria in the last Africa Cup of Nations twice in the preliminaries and also in the finals. Mm-hmm. And we also have a team like Cameroon, who have also proven to be a hard team to beat. You remember in the AAG All Africa Games, they beat Kenya in the first match in the preliminaries, but Kenya bounced back in the finals and they beat them. There's also Egypt and Tunisia, who are also still strong teams in Africa. So it's not going to be an easy tournament for Kenya. You also remember that the current squad, I think all of them, the last time Kenya featured in the Olympics, it was maybe in 2004, and most of them were either maybe still in primary school. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be a tough task for the since because maybe having sidelined Wanja, who played the last Olympics. Yeah. They are all going there for their debuts.
For their debuts. Yeah, they tinkered with that team because of several issues. They said they wanted, you know, to make the team, you know, grow, introduce new blood. How much of a factor will it be, the fact that some players have been sidelined?
It might work for us. It might work against us. Mm-hmm. But Mnala was very confident that he has the ladies who can perform better. And I was looking at the inclusion of Godensia Makoha. Mm-hmm. We have seen her the way she performed for the under 23. We know she's a good player. And the return of Joan Jelagat, we know there are players who can do well. But I think we'll also have to rely on Jane Washu. Those players of that experience, we know what they did here in the African Cup of Nations. But as Eshitemi put it, it's like they will get that is competition from Algeria. We know how Algeria can be. We know Egypt, the rivalry between Kenya and Egypt. So I think those are the two countries, the two nations, which will make it very hard for us. I think it will be good for us to start better. And if we fail to win, then let us try at least to make the first three positions, because it will be important for us. We'll stand a chance of maybe.
Yeah. You've been talking to Japheth Mnala, the coach, and I know you are also always following the technical director, that is David Lungao. What is the thinking of the Federation, especially going into this tournament in Cameroon?
Not only the Federation, but also the government. They have promised to give them full support. And as far as Mnala and Lungao are concerned, actually, they're also happy. Why? Because they've been given an additional position whereby they're taking 14 teams instead of 13. Uh-huh. That is the inclusion of Agrippina Kundu, who is a liberal. So she'll have to compete for starting position with the experienced Elizabeth Wanyama. So it's going to be a tournament to watch for both technical bench and the players themselves.
We've seen that Algeria has always been the stumbling block to Kenya, but then we've beaten Kenya, Algeria in the last I think two tournaments, in retaining the African Nations Cup and also in the World Cup qualifiers. Do you think we can continue with that trend?
Yeah, actually, right now we are on the right track, and look, that winning mentality is still in the players. Mm. This it is the same squad, apart from few changes. Mm. So there's nothing to worry about that. I believe this team has what it takes to beat Algeria again.
Mm. Mm. What about the fact that maybe Cameroon has not really been a very good hunting ground, and the fact that Cameroon are really coming up? Do you expect an upset?
No, a horse and a donkey. Yeah, those are two different animals. A horse will always remain a horse, yeah. The donkey will always remain a donkey. Mm. So
you think Cameroon cannot surprise?
To me, Cameroon, despite the fact that they'll be playing at home, mm. I don't think they are at par with the likes of Algeria, Kenya, Egypt. Mm. I think, yes, they'll give their best, but they'll struggle. I'm not seeing them surprising.
Yeah, going forward, as we wrap up, Ishtemi, your final comments. You've been very close to this team. How is their mindset? How do they have the mentality of conquerors?
Yeah, they have, because most of the players want to go out there, and maybe it's their first Olympic, and they want to qualify for Brazil. So there's no time to rest. They aren't resting on their laurels. So it's a matter of do or die. Mm. So I believe they have what it takes. It's a young and experienced squad, which has actually played at international level. Last year they did very well. So most of them expect to continue from where they left off last year.
Do you think having international friendlies will help this team?
Yeah, definitely it will. Why? Because they'll gain, achieve one or two, three things. But Robin Toskin, I want to put it like this. Malkia Strikers, they have been our best team. You cannot compare them with Harambee Stars. You cannot compare them with Shujaa. And I think they will still make Kenya proud. They will go, they will stand tall, and I'm telling you, we'll be in Brazil.
Thank you, gentlemen. Seth Onseri, the sports commentator. Rogers Ishtemi, our reporter. You've come through here and helped us dissect all to do with what happened over the weekend. This has been the Sports Chat segment of Morning Express. I've been your presenter, Robin Toskin. Until next Monday. Bye-bye.